Hey guys, we are back with another episode of The Royal Family, and in this episode, so it has been some time since the last episode, so we want to say like a few weeks have passed. Obviously, there was a lot of drama in the last episode, as you guys saw. Basically, what has happened is that they determined that Hannah's death was from a heart attack and that she was already having heart problems before Mackay broke up with her, way before. He just wasn't aware of them. Ultimately, it was not his fault that she died. He blamed himself, but Amira and his cousin Leilana, they convinced him that it wasn't his fault and that he should not feel guilty. I had a lot of people saying in the comments that Mackay was a killer, or that even if he didn't do it intentionally, he killed Hannah. And I don't want you guys to think that. It was just a coincidence, a very, very unfortunate coincidence that Mackay got stuck in. But I don't want you guys to think poorly of Mackay, because he has, and anyone has every right to get out of a relationship that they don't want to be in. So I'm not going to punish Mackay for doing that. I don't think anyone should punish Mackay for doing that. I know it probably would have been interesting to have this whole like murder mystery thing, but that's not what I wanted to focus on in this series. But yes, it was just a very unfortunate thing that had happened to Mackay, and it created a lot of tension between Hannah's family and his family, because they were all really good friends, or like his parents are really close with Hannah's family and they basically all grew up together. Things have started to die down in Sulani for sure, but Mackay ended up just running away and did not want to have anything to do with his mother anymore. He knew that something was going to happen, and his family knew that he is not in love with Hannah, or that he really didn't want to be in this arranged marriage. I think Hannah's family kind of knew that Mackay didn't love Hannah either, but I think that Mackay's mother is very aware that Mackay has run away to be with Amira. I'm trying to explain this to as clearly as I can. Hopefully I'm not leaving out too much information for you guys. But yes, so Mackay's mother is very aware that he has run away to Windenburg. She's convinced that it is to be with Amira. I don't think they know for sure that Mackay had broken up with Hannah before she died. And I don't think her family is still aware of that either. But Leilana's father, which is Mackay's mother's brother, had to go and talk to her and basically convince her to let Mackay be, like, he is a grown man. He gets to choose his own path. You can't force your children to do this and to be in arranged marriage. So that all happened. Now Mackay is in Windenburg. Amira was able to convince her father to let Mackay stay temporarily in their royal summer home. And this is where they stayed when the Windenburg Palace was being renovated. It did take a little bit of convincing, but I think that Henry trusts Amira and he does think Mackay's a good person. But Mackay has started to, he wants to get more into politics and do more charity work, and he's doing this because he wants to marry Amira one day, but he wants the blessing of King Henry and the approval of the kingdom too. So he's working as hard as he can to help Amira and just support her when she becomes ruler of Windenburg. And King Henry is nervous about Amira and Mackay ending up together, but I do think that he trusts Amira, and he's just waiting to see if the kingdom will kind of just approve of Mackay. But they do definitely have to take their relationship slow just until this whole thing about Hannah's death blows over. A lot of people don't know that Mackay broke up with Hannah before she died. They just think that he was upset when Hannah died, and they don't know that Amira and Mackay are together, but they think that he's just kind of like looking for a second chance. And then I think they will wait a while before they announce their relationship until everything blows over and all that. But that is what is going on with them. I'm sure Leilana felt really bad too, but she is aware that it was not their fault. It was just a really bad coincidence. But We are going to revisit this in another episode. In this episode, I wanted to focus a little bit more on the kids, and I also want to focus on Lady Harmony and Prince Dean and their plots to get revenge on Queen Lindsay. I do want to start with the kids. I'm trying to think of the best place to do this. Maybe we'll go ahead and start playing from Princess Arya's point of view, so the royal family of Oasis Springs. I do still need to age up Princess Kimberly and Princess Genevieve, but it's only been a short amount of time since their older siblings aged up into children, so I think I'm just going to wait a little bit more. Also, the Willow Creek royal family is in Granite Falls currently because their palace is being renovated. So I have one of my patrons who I've mentioned in the past, her name is Lily. She's amazing at building. It's crazy. It does not take long for her at all too. Like, she does these builds so quickly and she only has the base game. And her builds are insane. So she is currently building the Willow Creek Royal Palace, and I am so excited. So we're going to say that the Willow Creek Royal Palace is renovated. Probably going to be able to show you guys in the next episode. It's just, I'm so excited. You guys saw in the last episode that Princess Arya has aged up. Oh, okay, start practicing your hiding. Look at Lady, or Princess, I always call her Lady. Princess Arya and Nea. She is beautiful, you guys. She's so, so gorgeous. You can't see it right now, but she has purple eyes because I forgot that Prince Philip has purple eyes. So she has purple eyes. She's so beautiful. Look at them together. Look at Queen Nea's look. She's so confident. She's such like a strong, confident woman. I love her so much. And her daughter's amazing, Princess Arya. Princess Arya is actually I looked at her traits and she's a genius. And her aspiration is the social aspiration. She's going to just kill it at life. She's one of my new favorites right now. And I also realized I never deleted Nea's henna from her wedding, so I forgot to do that. But anyway, we created a royal kids club, or I did like a royal and noble kids club, although currently it's only royal children at the moment because, oh no, just kidding. We have Lord Nathaniel here because that's Princess Corinne's younger brother. I have not gotten the chance to add Prince Cornelius, Princess Anya, and I'm missing some other people as well. They just need to get like a lot more club points for me to do that. I actually might change over to either Princess Araminta's point of view, or maybe Princess Araminta's point of view, because I might bring Princess Anya here too. But a lot of people were saying that Prince Charles and Princess Araminta, they think would be really cute together. And I did want to focus more on the kids just so we could also see who else might be good together. But then some people were also saying that maybe Araminta and Charles would just be good friends. So we can kind of see who everyone would get along with. But yes, let me go ahead and switch to the control of Princess Araminta. Okay, so I am now playing from the royal family of Glimmerbrook. I was actually pleasantly surprised because I just did that poll on my community post so you guys could vote for your favorite royal families besides the Windenburg and Willow Creek royal family, because we do spend a lot of time on them. So I figured they would be mostly everyone's favorite. But the Glimmerbrook royal family was like the number one by a lot too. I was surprised. I thought it might be Brindleton Bay or Oasis Springs or something like that. Oasis Springs is probably one of my favorites, but so is Glimmerbrook too. I really love the Glimmerbrook royal family. Okay, now would be a really good time to have a pool. I used to have a pool here, but I got rid of it to make like this courtyard, like throne room thing, but it was a really cool pool. It came with the palace one. When I had downloaded it from the gallery, but yeah, it was really awesome. I did see that people were saying that, again, Araminta and Charles, they would be really cute together, so I guess we'll kind of see. Obviously, we can't really do romantic interactions when they are kids, but we can see who's kind of getting along more with who. I have not spent as much time with the kids as I should, but also people were saying, maybe Araminta. I feel like she's going to be the type, oh gosh, try to pick a fight, jeez, Araminta. But I feel like she's going to try to be the type to want whatever Araminta, or did I say Araminta? Anya is the type to want whatever Araminta has. So I feel like if Araminta has a crush on Charles, then Anya would try to take Charles from her. I see that happening. Although right now Araminta is talking to Princess Diana. I have to see also who Diana and Bellatrix would be good with. But yeah, I was hoping we would have a lot more time to do this, but they actually do have to go to school soon, unfortunately. I also wanna see who Princess Arya would be good with. Maybe Lord Nathaniel? Oh, but now it looks like Anya is talking to Arya when Araminta was already studying with Arya. Although Araminta finished her homework and Anya didn't. Anya, you have to get on it. But yeah, I feel like her goal in life is just to take whatever Araminta has. I feel like she's like that sister. Now they're both talking to, oh my gosh, there's too many A names. Now they're both talking to Arya. Oh yeah, Arya, Araminta, Anya, Mira. Oh my gosh, they all start with A and end with A. Oh shoot, but yeah, it looks like all the kids are already going to school. So that's not what I wanted to happen so quickly. Oh, this is a Princess Aisha. I keep forgetting to put Aisha. Oh yeah, and then Aisha, although that one was suggested by a viewer and I love that name too, but it starts with A and ends with A also. So I should probably branch out a little bit on my names, but they're already going to school. I wanted to focus more on the kids. Sorry guys, there's really not much you can do though as like children. Like there's not that many interactions you could do. Maybe we will come back to this. I don't have enough club points to add more people, but I wanted to add like a lot more people. But we'll just come back to this, it's fine. For now, I do want to go to Lady Harmony and Prince Dean because there is some plotting going on over there. So we are here with Harmony and Dean and it is very dark, I'm realizing that now. I can't seem to get the lights to turn on. I think because it is daytime, but it's just raining a lot. Oh gosh, what am I doing? Yeah, it's just raining a lot, which I feel like is very fitting for the fact that they are plotting right now. So I was trying to think of how exactly they would be getting revenge on Queen Lindsay, because if you saw the 100th episode of The Royal Family, you saw that that was their plan, is to get revenge, and Harmony was able to convince her brother, Prince Dean, to help them. If you guys saw the royalty mod video, you know that we can have royal nannies. You actually need to have the sim living in the same household to have a royal nanny. So I'm thinking their plan, since they don't know what Charlotte looks like now that she has grown up, Queen Lindsay could 100% spot Harmony and also the governess that was living with them, but she wouldn't be able to recognize Charlotte. So I think they're going to try and have a heart, or not Harmony, have Charlotte be the governess or the royal nanny for the Oasis Springs royal family. And that way she would have like a way in. I think what they'd want to do is have Charlotte become and like come out to the kingdom that Charlotte is the daughter of King Adrian. So she is not the first in line for the throne, obviously, but she would be eligible for the throne. I did not have the royalty mod back then, but what I could have done is established her as an illegitimate royal, I think was what it would be. I think technically I can have Queen Nea establish her as an illegitimate royal, but we would pretend like Queen Nea doesn't know about her because Queen Nea doesn't know about her. I don't think Queen Lindsay ever told her, or I don't think her mother ever told her about her father's mistresses and bastard children, because I feel like she was embarrassed about it. But obviously she's gonna have to tell her when all of this stuff comes out and when Queen, or yeah, when Nea finds out about it. But yeah, So that's the plan. So I'm thinking now we're going to have Charlotte, you know what? She needs like a better outfit though. Like she can't just show up in these clothes. I mean, she could show up in this clothing. I don't think that's horrible, but we're going to have Charlotte go to the Oasis Springs royal family because I feel like there has been a notice that they are looking for a, I'm used to saying like, I feel like governess would be the same. I don't know if a governess and royal nanny are the same thing. Oh, a governess is a woman employed to teach children in a private household. So I feel like they're looking more for a nanny than an actual teacher for the kids. Also, I feel like Charlotte wouldn't qualify to be a teacher because of where they're from. I do need to have them move somewhere. I'm thinking Prince Dean would convince Leilana to either give them a nicer home or to stay with them. I should have done that by now, honestly. That probably would have happened by now. Or just rebuild on this lot. I'll probably do that. We'll just say it's in the works and they're staying at the Sulani Royal Family Palace every once in a while. But yes, so a notice has come out for a royal nanny because the royal family of Oasis Springs has 4 children. 3 of them are toddlers. I think they need a little bit of help. Queen Lindsay is kind of back and forth, but Queen Lindsay is also getting older. Oh, also Queen Cora aged up into an elder. I realized, or someone told me that she was actually older than King Edmund, but for some reason it said she was younger. I think it's just because when the Sim is pregnant, it disallows aging. But yeah, so she's now an elder. I completely missed her aging up, unfortunately. But Harmony, oh my god, I'm gonna keep calling her Harmony. Charlotte is here. So she's gonna knock on the door. She has seen that there is want for a royal nanny. So I'm thinking if she can become friends with Naya, if they get a good relationship with Naya and Philip, I think she needs to convince both of them, then I'm gonna have her move in with them and become their royal nanny. And they're not going to know who she is or anything. She should probably introduce herself to Princess Ari. Oh, okay, so that's another thing. She has to attempt an introduction. So the best bet would probably be to attempt an introduction with Princess Aria first, because Aria, as a child, she's only a notable newcomer, but her parents are like global superstars, or at least Naya is. But I do want her to imply Princess Aria is overrated. Well, don't do that. Although, Charlotte cannot do very many interactions. And I wonder if it's because Arya's a child. Okay, but now she needs to attempt an introduction with Prince Philip, and I need to bring Queen Naya over here too. Okay, well, she's screaming and attempting an introduction. That's probably not making the best impression. If this doesn't work too, I think we're definitely gonna have her try to come back or like find another way to get closer to the royal family of Oasis Springs. It's kind of scary though, the fact that they're trying to do this and the fact that she would be living in their house if this worked out. It doesn't look like it worked with Philip though. Like she really doesn't know anyone. It wouldn't be like attempting an introduction. Oh, whoa, what are these moodlets? Close to greatness and near the monarch. Oh yeah. She's really not able to talk to them, you guys. And I don't wanna use like a cheat or anything. How do I get a relationship between them? This is going to be difficult. Oh, but she can introduce herself to the toddlers and they need their diaper changed. So if she changes their diaper, will that help that their parents like become more interested in her? Maybe she has to just like show that she's qualified to take care of their children. Okay, Charlotte has become very close now to the children of Oasis Springs. So we might have to try to do this again with the attempt introduction and see if Naya and Philip talk to her. I do think that Charlotte is very aware of this plan and her mother has brought her into this, telling her that she is the daughter of the former king of Oasis Springs and that her life would be so much better if she were able to get revenge on Queen Lindsay. So she has convinced her daughter to do basically this horrible thing. But Charlotte is completely on board. Charlotte is hot-headed, jealous, and dastardly. So I think she's on the verge of being pretty evil. She definitely wants revenge for what she should have had, I think is what she sees it as. And I mean, their life has been so horrible. So she definitely thinks that Queen Lindsay is to blame for that. So let's try to have her do another try to attempt an introduction. And this is what I'm thinking is just like she needed to impress Philip and Naya to be able, like by watching their kids and forming a good relationship with them, for them to think that she was a good fit to like be the nanny. She just attempted another introduction. Did it not work again? She was really close to the kids. I mean, she has such a high relationship with their children, which is kind of terrifying if we think about it. Let's have her try to attempt another introduction with Queen Naya, because I had her talk to her kids a little bit. Oh, now there's just like a random school project in the middle of the palace hallway. Okay, did it work? Oh my gosh, wait, it worked. Guys, okay. Well, she was able to talk to Naya, and now I guess has gotten their approval. Downplay stress. Let's try this with Philip again, because I do think she needs both of their approval. I think it worked. Brighten day, because now she can do interactions with him, even though it says there's no relationship at all. But I think it worked, you guys. She's able to talk to them now, which to me, I feel like is like she's gotten their approval. She's impressed them by the way she was handling the kids and talking to them, and now has such a strong relationship with the kids. Like they really took to her. So I do feel like this means, I know she doesn't have that much of a relationship though. Praise the monarch. Yes, do that in front of her. Okay. Now she's getting a little bit more of a relationship, but I feel like this means that they are going to hire her to be their royal nanny, which means she's going to move in with them. Like they're telling her like, okay, like you've done so great with our kids. Oh, that's a wall. Like go home, pack your things. You're moving in here to take care of them. So Charlotte has gotten in to the Oasis Springs royal family. She now has an inside scoop of everything, and this is making her so much closer to Queen Lindsay now too. So that's going to be interesting. I think we're going to end this episode here. In the next episode, or in one of the episodes, I don't think it'll be the next episode, but we will revisit this situation and we will have Charlotte move in to the Oasis Springs Royal Palace. We are probably gonna see her a lot more often now if she is living in the Oasis Springs Royal Palace. Sorry we did not get to focus on the kids as much as I wanted to because they had to go to school, which is important, I understand. But we'll definitely get to keep focusing on them in other episodes. We also will be having the royal wedding of Brindleton Bay soon. So if you enjoyed this episode, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on your notifications. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!